Hey everyone, thank you for stopping by. If you're new here, my name is Jyoti. I hope you're having a wonderful day today. In today's video, we're going to be painting Edward Scissorhands, and I also have a spooky story for you as a part of the Spooktober series. So without any further ado, let's begin. Today's video is about black-eyed children. Now, black-eyed children are paranormal creatures that resemble children between the age 6 and 16. They're said to have pale skin and pitch black eyes and are often seen hitchhiking or panhandling, or they just straight up come to your doorstep and knock on the door. They do not look threatening. They would want to get into your car or your house, and they will be persistent. But no matter what happens, do not let them in. They appear like any ordinary kids, but some reports state that they would be wearing attires that are outdated. And anyone who has encountered them has immediately felt this overwhelming sense of dread. No one really knows how or when these creatures pop up, and conspiracy theorists claim that these creatures are like aliens who are trying to reach out to Earth. And demonologists believe that they're the children of the devil himself, and if you let them in, you're allowing the devil to enter your life. Some people claim that these children have existed since the 1980s, but most of the sources say that this legend originated in 1996 in posts written by a Texas reporter named Brian Bethel. I'm going to read out one of the stories reported by him. So one of the stories goes like this. In the snowy town within the middle of nowhere of Vermont, an elderly couple heard the sound of three loud knocks on their door. They opened the door and saw two children, a boy and a girl. "Parents will be here soon. May we come in?" The children did not make eye contact and just stood there in the doorway. The elderly couple were hesitant, but after a while, they let the boy and the girl inside. The kids settled on the couch while the wife made some hot cocoa and the husband asked them questions that went unanswered. The wife returned and noticed that her cat was scared and angry with the children. "May we please use the restroom?" The wife looked at the kids and she finally saw them. The children's eyes were as black as the starless universe. She directed them to the bathroom and returned to her husband, who was covering his face with his hand. "Did you see their eyes?" The husband then showed her his hand full of blood from a nosebleed. The power suddenly went out and the house turned as dark as the kids' eyes. The wife headed to the restroom and was confronted by the voice of the kids at the end of the hall uttering, "Our parents are here." The kids then exited the house, leaving the door wide open. The wife then noticed that there were two men at the end of the driveway. The men were very tall and slender. The wife waved but did not receive the same friendly gesture. The two men and the children then drove away together in one car. The power then came back on a little later after the kids left. Throughout the next week, weird things happened in the house. Three of the four cats went missing and the fourth had been found dead in the pool of its blood. The husband continued to have nosebleeds and finally went to the doctor, where he was diagnosed with aggressive skin cancer. Nowadays, people still claim to see the black-eyed children while driving late at night down an empty road or outside of their window late at night, or even lurking in the shadows of their room. Many people have reported seeing the black-eyed children standing in the corner of their room during their episodes of sleep paralysis, or even waking up in the middle of the night because they sensed someone was watching them. I'm going to read out some more encounter stories. So here's another one. It's called My Black-Eyed Kid Encounter by Jake. So black-eyed kids. The mere idea of them terrifies me. It didn't used to. In fact, I didn't understand what the big deal was. I don't know why. I mean, I read the online stories and articles about black-eyed kids just like everyone else, but I just didn't have the same visceral reaction so many other people did when reading about them. So I embarked on a quest. I'd show people just how unscary these things were, whatever they were. Who knew if black-eyed kids was even a real thing? I mean, I'm the kind of person who needs to see it for myself. I began doing a lot of research online. I looked at paranormal sites, I watched scary videos on YouTube about black-eyed kids, and from everything I gathered, they found you. You didn't find them. And it seemed like it was pretty much just by chance if they did find you. So what was I to do? I came up with a plan. I began putting up anonymous ads on Craigslist. It read, black-eyed kids, I'm not afraid of you. I want to meet you. 9 p.m. Wednesday. The park bench on the corner of 3rd and Washington. Show me why I'm wrong and why I should be afraid. The bench was only like a block from my apartment. So every Wednesday, I would walk down there and see if anyone or anything came by. I usually wouldn't sit there. I'd stand back and watch. I'm not stupid. I may not be afraid for black-eyed kids, but I know the internet can attract some nuts, and it did, occasionally. Nothing excited enough to write about though, a couple of pearls and some teenage kids joking around. So this went on for 6 months and then I stopped posting the ad. The week I stopped, I got a knock on my door. I was sitting on my couch and it was a little after 9 p.m. I don't know how to explain it, but the second I heard that knock, my skin went ice cold. Ice cold. I didn't need to get up. I knew who it was, and much to my surprise, I was terrified already. I was wrong about not being afraid of the black-eyed kids. The fear is on a different level, an instinctual level, a primal level. But still, I managed to get up and I opened the door. And yep, there was a kid, about 9 years old. Olive skin, dark hair, solid black eyes, staring up at me. Can I come in? He asked. I was speechless. After what seemed like an eternity, I responded with a no, and I began closing the door. We missed you at the park tonight, the boy said. I stopped closing the door. I looked at him, my mind racing. They've been watching me? The boy smiled up at me. It took everything I had to make my arm move again, pushing the door closed and locking it. As soon as I shut the door, I gasped for air. I hadn't been breathing. I sat back against my wall facing the closed door. Knock, knock, knock. He was still there. I waited. Nothing. It took me at least an hour to move from that spot, staring at the door. I didn't sleep that night or the next night. Eventually, I collapsed with exhaustion at my desk at work, only to be awakened minutes later by a nightmare memory of that boy. It's been 6 months. I can't explain the fear that washes over your body when you see the eyes of these kids. And the state of your mind, the way your body wants to listen to what they're telling you, what they're asking. I thought if I told you my story, it would help me get over what happened and warn others. I'm positive these kids are evil, and the people they meet who can't resist whatever power they wield, I don't think we will ever hear from those people. I now avoid that corner park bench with everything I have, and I don't tell anyone why. People think I'm crazy sometimes, walking 3 blocks out of the way just to make sure I don't go near it. But you'd be the same way if you went through what I did. Black-eyed kids are nothing to mess with. That's it for today's video, guys. I wanted to add more encounter stories, but that construction sound in the background is so annoying, so I just gave up. So I'll see you in my next video. Until then, bye.